duty to take care and the care is not taken, resulting into an injury. Now, there are basically two types of theories which are given under law of negligence. The first one is subjective theory, second one is objective theory. So, as the name suggests, subjective theory, it was given by the famous thinker Salmond. Now, what he said that in negligence, mens rea is involved. What is the meaning of mens rea? Mental element means a person's state of mind is involved in doing negligence. But in opposite, objective theory was laid down by Pollock and he said that negligence is not a state of mind. It is an act and it is an independent thought. Now, when we talk about negligence, there are basically three essential elements which are considered to be a negligent act. The first one is that the defendant owed the duty of care towards plaintiff. Then, defendant committed that breach of duty. And because of that breach of duty, plaintiff suffered damage as a consequence of that breach of duty. And that particular damage can be said as proximate damage. Now, there was a very famous case law, Donoghue versus Stevenson, which was also known as ginger beer case. What happened in this particular case, there was a lady who went to a beer shop and she took a beer. In her beer, there was a decomposed nail and because of drinking that particular beer, she fell ill and she sued the person who was running that particular restaurant. Now, what happened? The district court, or we can say that session court, dismissed the appeal. Now she goes to House of Appeal and there Lord Acton laid the principle of neighborhood and sued the manufacturer for the negligent act. Now there is one famous principle known as res ipsa loquitur, which is the exception to the proof of negligence, where defendant do not have to prove that he has committed some negligent act. Now, what does this maxim says? It says, thing speaks for itself. There was very famous case law, Municipal Corporation versus Subhagwanti Devi. There was a clock tower in Chandni Chowk in Delhi. It fell down. It was 45 or 50 years old and Municipal Corporation do not pay attention in maintaining that particular clock tower. It fell down and because of falling that particular clock tower, the plaintiff's husband was died. So Bhagwanti's husband was died and she filed a case against the Municipal Corporation. So here, the falling of that clock tower was itself the fact. So here, the defendant does not have to produce that there was a negligent act. The thing was speaking for itself. So this was all about your negligence and what does negligence mean under law of tort.